For decades, Winston Peters had an office inside Parliament. Now he's being trespassed from the precinct for this 30-minute wander among the protesters in February. The letter dropped on his doorstep.
You had to think it was a hoax, but then I found out that they were serious, and so I'm taking action on it.
That's legal action he's talking about.
People have a right to protest in this country. It is a key point of democracy. You take that away, whether you agree with them or not, you take that away, and we're living in a dictatorship.
Former ACT MP Stephen Franks found out he was on the list in a very Kiwi way when he bumped into the Speaker.
I was at a restaurant, he was at the next table, and I went over to chat to him.
One News broke the story last night, and it now means the former National MP Matt King can't launch his new political party on Parliament grounds as planned.
It's political. I think it's an attempt to muzzle people.
You should have been even-handed. The Shelley Bay people should have been moved on. The Ihumatao protesters shouldn't have been rewarded. It's wrong.
This morning, the Prime Minister staying out of it.
This is a decision for the Speaker.
But once her former coalition partner got involved, things changed.
What do you make of Winston Peters being trespassed from Parliament?
Look, ultimately, this is a decision for the Speaker, but we've spoken this afternoon. I've encouraged him to give the opportunity for all of the parties within Parliament to discuss the issue.
And after that encouragement, a committee met to debate whether former MPs can be exempt from the two-year ban. Parliamentary security are identifying the protesters and working with police to issue trespass notices.
Mr Speaker, I hope you don't trespass me.
The member does know that my rights within here are pretty much absolute.
The Speaker said no thanks to an interview today, but this trespass story has prompted his political foes to call for his resignation again.
Has Trevor Mallard overstepped the mark here?
No, not at all.
Weeks later, the protest fallout is still being felt. Jessica Much-Mackay, One News.